Let's study bubble sort, the simplest of the sorting techniques for any data structure implementation. Now, what is a bubble sort? Now, bubble sort algorithms cycle through a list, analyzing pairs of elements from left to right or beginning to end. If the leftmost element in the pair is less than the rightmost element, the pair will remain in that order. If the rightmost element is less than the leftmost element, then the two elements will be switched. This is the condition if we are trying to sort the numbers from smallest to largest. The condition will reverse if you are trying to sort the numbers from largest to smallest. This cycle repeats from beginning to end until a pass in which no switch occurs. This is a technical definition and the outline structure of a bubble sort. Now let's see how it works. The bubble sort requires very little memory other than that which the array or the list itself occupies. So bubble sort will be used to sort number of elements in an array. The bubble sort is comprised of relatively few lines of codes that you will see when we do the programming. With a best case running time of big O n, this is the time complexity of a bubble sort. The bubble sort is good for testing whether or not a list is sorted or not, and it is good for small numbers of elements in an array. Other sorting methods often cycles through their whole sorting sequence, which often have running time of O n raised to the power of 2 or O n log n for this task. We will see all the sorting videos that are following. Here we will be doing the bubble sort. The same applies for the data set that have only few items that need to be swapped a few times. So the bubble sort works best if my elements in the list are less. The main disadvantage of bubble sort method is the time it requires. If my list becomes larger, then bubble sort takes a lot of time, because in bubble sort we compare each element with each other element in the array. With a running time of O n square, it is highly inefficient for the large data set, and this is a running time for a large data set in the worst case complexity. Now let's take a list. We'll take an example of how actually bubble sort works. This is the original list of elements. I have numbers 25, 86, 56, 13 and 45. So this is a small list with 5 elements. Now what happens in pass 1? In pass 1, we'll be comparing. This will be my first element and these are the remaining elements. So we take this element as ith element, and this j will start from I plus 1. We will see in the programming pseudocode why does it have an I plus 1. So 25 will be compared with 86, as we're trying to arrange the numbers from smallest to largest. So 25 is less than 86, so there will not be any swapping happening over here, so switching of data will not be there. So my list remains as it is. Now next comparison will be between 25 and 56. Here also 25 is less than 56. As my 25 is less than 56, there will not be any swapping of data that will happen. Now comes 25 will 13. Yes, 25 is greater than 13, so the data will be exchanged and the value of 13 will go here and the value of 25 will come here. And after my swap, 13 comes here, and 13, if I compare with the last element, 45, it is less. So after pass 1, after having this, the 13 will again be compared with 45. As 13 is less than 45, this will remain fixed over here. So 13, the smallest element in my array, after pass 1, I've got the first element. After I get the first smallest element at its place, it is known as pass 1 of a sort. Now let's see what happens next. In the pass 1, so for the next pass, this is my list. In second pass, what happens? This is my I and this is my J. So I'll be comparing. So 86 with 56. Is 86 less than 56? No, 86 is greater than 56. And we are sorting from smallest to largest. So there will be a swap which will happen over here like this. And my list becomes 56, 86, 25 and 45. Now, this element over here will again be compared with 25. You will see in bubble sort, J is incremented by 1, but I remains fixed till it gets the sorted element. Yes, 56 is greater than 25. So, there will be a swap happening. So, 25 will come here and 56 will go here. So, my list becomes 13, which is a fixed element, 25, 86, 56 and 45. Now, what happens next? I'll compare 25 with 45. Yes, 25 is less than 45. So, there will not be any swapping happening. And this is the last element of my list. So, after pass 2, I've got 2 elements which have got the fixed location. So, it is 13 and 25. After it is done, we increment I by 1. Now, my I is at 86 and J is at 56. And we compare in the pass 3, 86 with 56. Yes, 86 is more than 56, so there will be a swapping happening over here. So, we swap the elements like this and the list becomes 56, 86, 45, 13 and 25 have got their fixed locations. Now, we compare 56 with 45. Yes, 56 is greater, so there will be again a swap happening. So, 45 will come over here and 56 will come over here. And my list becomes 45, 86, 56. So, there will not be any swap after that. So, after pass 3, my location is, my fixed numbers are 13, 25, 45. So, now this will go as an input to pass 4. In pass 4, what happens? I compare 86 with 56. Yes, 86 is greater. So, there will be a swap which will happen over here. And my list becomes 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86. So, my 56 gets its final position. So, 4 elements in my list are sorted. This is the last element. So, by default, it gets its final position is fixed. So, the sorted list after the pass 4 is 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86. You will see for a bubble sort, the number of passes required are n minus 1. So, if there are 5 elements in my list, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of passes required are 5 minus 1, that is 4. So, number of passes required to sort the elements in bubble sort is n minus 1. Now, this is the program of execution of a bubble sort. Let's start. Hash include stdio.h, int main, int array. Array is where it can hold 100 elements, n, I, j and temp. These are the loop variables. Now, enter the number of elements in the array. Scanf percentage n. So, how many elements I need? I need 5 elements. We have put in here 5. So, it is enter the 5 elements. So, enter the 5 integers. So, phi is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. I scan. So, these 5 elements are scanned into my array. Now, let's start. Now, we start with I is equal to 0, I less than n minus 1, I plus plus. Why do we start with I is equal to 0 to I less than n minus 1? As you had seen that the last element which was compared, the I value was here. It never compared itself with the last element. So, we need to increment I to n minus 1. So, it will be less than 4. So, I was incremented till here. So, it will be 0, 1, 2 and 3. And for j is equal to I plus 1 to j less than n. Now, this I plus 1 is very important. Because if my ith element is at 25, I need to start comparing it from the next element, not from the ith itself. I don't have to compare for sorting element with itself over here. So, we do always for a bubble sort, value of I and jth loop, the inner loop will always vary for I plus 1. Now, let's start. If array of I is greater than array of j, here it is. 25 is compared with 86. Is array of I greater than array of j? No, it is not. So, what happens? This will not enter this loop. This statements will not be executed. If loop will close, as my for loop closes over here, the value of j will be incremented by 1. So, j will now come to 56. So, this is the element which will be compared. Array of I greater than array of j. 25 is not greater than 56, So this part also is ruled out. There is no swapping that will happen. So J will again be incremented, and now my cursor is here. My value of J is this. So as my value of J is 13, array of I is greater than array of J. Yes, 25 is greater than 13. So we enter this loop, and it is temp is equal to array of I. So whatever is the value of array of I, that is 25. So my temp now becomes 25 over here. Array of I is equal to array of J. What is the value of array of J? 13. So this 25 will now be replaced with 13. And array of J is equal to temp. So wherever I had stored 25 will now be 25 over here. So this is how my array will be swapped. This is a common function of writing or common statements for the swap function. Now what happens next is, if I do this, now it is 13, 86, 56, 25 and 45. Next, 13 will be compared with 45. So array of I is greater than array of J? No. So after pass 1, this is what will happen. Pass 1 will give me this answer. 13, this is what happens when I enter the pass 1, the original list, and this is what happens when I have done with pass 1. So what happens? Pass 1, I've got 13 fixed. J loop has reached the end. So J loop closure. Now I will be incremented by 1, so my I becomes at 86. It again enters the loop. J is equal to I plus 1. I was 1, so now J will be 2. So J will start from here. As J will start from here, array of I is greater than array of J? Yes, 86 is greater than 56. So it will enter into the loop and the values will be swapped. Let's see swapping again. Temp is equal to array of I. So now in this case, array of I is 86. So now temp becomes 86. Array of I is equal to array of J. Array of J holds what? 56. So this becomes now 56. And array of J is equal to temp. So temp becomes 86. So these two values are swapped between itself. So this procedure will continue till we get all the elements swapped. So after pass 2, it will be 13, 25, 86, 56, 45. After pass 3, 13, 25, 45, 86, 56. After pass 4, 13, 25, 45, 56, 86. And pass 5, that is the sorted list, is 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86. We've got this sorted list. Now printf, the sorted list in ascending order. C is equal to 0, C less than n, C plus plus, and percentage d slash n array of C return 0. We are doing return 0 because in front of main we have written int main. So return 0 has to be there, otherwise error will come. So percentage d slash n, it will take us to the next line. So my output will be 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86 as the sorted elements of my array using a bubble sort. Thank you.